Hi, today I'm gonna explain in depth in Kowloon's video uploaded in YouTube or Reddit Helldivers. Since I'm not a native English speaker, my English is very slow and the pronunciation is not good. So if you feel it's too slow, then please set your playing speed like 1.5 or 2.0 so that it will be faster and not boring. You will not get bored. So please understand my murmuring and hesitating. Her video is very good, very informative, but I wanted to add more explanation to understand well. She also asked me to do that because she and I are the close friend. This is the what we talk about. It's written in Korean, so it's not for you guys. It's written for my preparation for the video. So anyway, first we're gonna talk about the basic things for RS. RS stands for Retaliatory Strike in Helldivers. So in RS, we will only talk about RS. So first we will talk about the basic things, and then the important thing is how the movement, rotation, and then the looking. Anyway, I will talk about that. I'm not good at English. And then we will talk about butchers, and then perk, and then warlord. So these are the contents of my video this time. So let's see her video. This is her video. It's also many parts are written in Korean, so it's not good for you guys to understand. So first let's go to okay. So first thing, it's a basic thing. You need to clear the ports, the ammos, and many things. So here are ammos and the EATs and so on. If you don't pick it up, it will remain, not forever, but for many minutes. If you pick this up, then this port, this is called the port, will be disappeared, will disappear. If it doesn't disappear, you cannot move through this port, so it is a very hindrance to your movement. So you need better to remove this port. One more reason you remove this port is if you don't pick this EAT right away, the EAT will disappear in many minutes, after many minutes. So But if you pick up like this, it will remove, it will remain forever. So this is the reason why you remove, you pick it up first. So this is what her, this is her talking. So let's see first. Yeah, he's picking up right now. And then the port will be disappeared, will disappear. Then you can move through the port. Yeah, it disappeared. Okay. Let's go to 2500. It's not working yet. So here it's in Starbucks, so it will be a little bit noisy. Sorry for I don't have appropriate place to record in a quiet place. So let's go to 2500. So what I want to show here is the importance of the SOS beacon. This is called the SOS beacon. Many Helldivers throw this, generates this beacon. The reason why they do this is there are many benefits, so it's important. There are more benefits than disadvantages, so it's better to use this beacon. You see, just you can see just one beacon here, but it's possible to generate like three beacons when. So when he is generating, holding a beacon and throwing a beacon, you, other guys also need to hold the beacon and throw it. Because after throwing this beacon, you these guys, if this guy throw the beacon once, then the other two guys will not have option to throw the beacon within 3 seconds, after 3 seconds. So it's better to throw the beacon at together at one time. So anyway, in this RS map, this is the rectangular RS map, which location is better? Is this, should we throw the beacon here or here, like here or here? So first thing, here is really not good. This is not good place because the basic thing in RS is the basic thing in RS is you better not stay here because it's more dangerous. You need to keep moving in the edge of the map, or clockwise or counterclockwise. It's up to you, but you need to better move here. So if there is a beacon here, it's a hindrance. You cannot move through the beacon, so it's hindrance. So then you need to decide the beacon location here. Uh, is it better to locate the Bitcoin here or here? There is pro and cons. Bitcoin, you can use a Bitcoin to stand up in front of the enemy when you are down, or like use a barricade to protect yourself from the enemy's shooting. But the bad thing about Bitcoin is when you stay like here and the warlords hit you here, because of the splash damage, you will hurt, or the IFB, like a tank, IFB, I will call it IFB, infantry vehicle. If it hits here, then because of the splash damage, you will down. So that's the disadvantage. One more disadvantage is you cannot move through the beacon. And another, the last disadvantage is when you want to shoot warlord when you are standing here, it's impossible because of the beacon. So it's especially not good when you are holding EAT and shoot it. It's impossible because of the beacon. So these are the pros and cons. So should I generate Bitcoin here or here? Which one is better, here or here? It's up to you. It's your preference. That's the conclusion. The reason is if you throw the Bitcoin here or here, there is more risk but more benefit. If you throw the Bitcoin here, there is less risk, but also less benefit. This is because, let's say first about when you throw the Bitcoin here in the center. It has less risk, less disadvantage. This is because you don't have a hindrance a lot, because you move the edge of the map, so you have less chance that you stay here, so it will not be a hindrance. Also, you can shoot anywhere with it. Like if you are standing here or here, and you want to shoot the enemy here, it's a hindrance because you cannot shoot through the beacon. But this chance is lower because you can shoot anywhere this angle. So so there is less risk, less disadvantage if you put the beacon here. But it's also less advantage. I will explain you why. If you put the beacon here, like here, when you are down at here, you are moving through the here, rotating, and when you are down at here, and the enemy is here, then it can be used as a, this beacon can be used as a barricade, so that you can save some time to stand up again. This is the advantage. And also, enemy cannot move through here. So it's very good for you. This is the advantage when you throw the beacon a little bit out of the center. So if you throw the beacon here, it has less disadvantage. So let's see the let's talk about more. This is the video that shows. This is the part of the video that shows beacon's disadvantage. The IFB tank shoot you, but even though it didn't shoot you directly, the ESN, the green one, downed because of the splash damage. Yeah, it got down because of the splash damage. Yeah. He didn't hit directly, but he got down because it hit here and you got it got down. It's a disadvantage. Splash damage can happen at any time, like if a tank hit here, or here, or here, anywhere, even your allies. So if tank hits here and then you stand here, then it can be also a splash damage. Let's see. Let's see 1-4. Let's see 1-4-5-0. Zekorax, see the yellow one. So, tank aimed, IFB aimed here. So she suddenly crouched because she didn't want to get hit by the splash damage. Okay, this is one example. Let's go to the 4013. In this video, because of the SOS beacon, it saved your life. It saved Hidetomi's life, the yellow one. So this is the advantage of the beacon. Let's see this video. See the Hidetomi. He's down. So let's assume this is a beacon. The beacon disappears when there is a call center for the returning ship. He'd get downed, but he could survive. If it were not the help of the big beacon, the warlord will come here and kill him. But it couldn't come across to him because of this this beacon. So it saved his life because it saved some time to get up, stand up again. Let's see again. Okay. So if you feel bored because you already know this, you better to move to the later part, final or the middle part of my video, because it will be more informative. It will give you the good information, good tricks and tips that you might not know. Let's go to 5240. So here I want to say, when the returning ship call arrives, the SOS beacon disappears. That is what I want to say. Let's see. It disappeared. Okay. And let's go to 2240. Here, what I want to say is, because of the SOS beacon, it's a disadvantage that you cannot shoot through the SOS beacon using EAT if you are holding EAT. So this is one of the disadvantages when you are using beacons. No, this is not what I wanted to say. Let's see here again. So watch the blue guy, Louis Chen. He shot the EAT to the herd, but it didn't work because of the SOS beacon. Yeah. This is the disadvantage. So let's go to 4700. What I want to say here is one of the advantage of SOS beacon, it protects you from the gunshot from the enemy. So watch here. So the herd is here and it's shooting, but you can see that the shooting is here, but it blocks the shooting here. So this is the advantage of SOS beacon. Let's see. Okay, these are the basic things, so it will be boring. Let's talk about the important thing. Maybe I will split the video so that you guys will easily see the important topics. I will end this recording now.